Hey, what's going on, everybody? January Flowers here, your favorite homegirl, and we have a lot of things to discuss today. Krishan is possibly going to the reunion. Stunner Girl says it wasn't Biggie, but Rolly says Biggie set up the original Stunner Girl. Do I believe it? No. If you're new to the channel and you love this type of content, like the video, consider subscribing. If you return into the channel, hey boo, run them likes up for the doll. Show your girl some love in that comment section. Now let's get into this tea. Y'all know yesterday on the live we was discussing all of this, right? Now my thing is, I don't know why people are ignoring what could have really happened. So this is the thing. From Sunday's episode, people are wondering who set up Stunner. Krishan and Stunner got on live to discuss it, and what they actually discussed was Biggie really the one capable of this? Now, the reason Stunner Girl said no is because she said it was girls from middle school who she had fought there, who was around her and stuff like that. Now, that's another reason to make me wonder, girl, why wasn't you alert? Hello? But anyway, she said it was girls like that. So Krishan, I guess, was saying like, oh, I thought they were saying Biggie set it up, because this is what Rolly said on her live. Now, before we go into Rolly's portion, let me let y'all hear a little bit of the conversation between Stunner Girl and Krishan.
So, I watched the last episode.
All right. I got questions for you, too, because I wasn't inside when the
shooting. How would you beef with those bitches?
Exactly. I don't even think she knew them either. She didn't know them either. There were some random bitches that got picked up.
So, you really think Biggie did it?
I don't think she... She's not capable of that, but she was talking to bitches like from my town that don't like me. Like, she talked to anybody that don't like me, like posting them on her story and like talking to them. Like, that's hella weird. I don't feel like that deep. Like, I'm not profiling bitches she don't like in her town. Like, I don't care. Like, I don't need help. Like, this bitch found bitches from like middle school that I fought and shit. Like, you guys could be bored.
Okay, so that was a little bit of the conversation. So like Stunner Girl said, you know, Biggie was reposting girls who didn't like her and stuff like that, doing kind of childish things. But what's accelerating this story and putting a lot of targets on Biggie is what Rolly had to say about the situation. Let's check this out.
Where Biggie was at, I'm about to tell y'all something that y'all don't know about that episode, right? So I guess she befriended a couple of girls from Baddies West auditions. Some of those girls in that audience was there because Biggie called them up there for Stunner Girl. So she's all the way in the back. You can't even see her. That's where she was. She's all the way in the back hiding. We're going to see who really her friend. We're going to see who really friends. When Tommy Stunner Girl people and them start going at her, we're going to see who really friends. Go ahead and help Tommy. She was in the back. I turned around. She was back there. I was like, okay. I'm in the front. Y'all want to know where Biggie was at?
So you see, they talking about the whole situation. Where was Biggie when Tommy was out there fighting and this and that? But so much was going on in the club. I can't say it was just that, you know, as the reason why she wasn't around. It could be, it could not be. I know it was speculations that it was Tommy who set all that up. But the thing is, while I was leaning more towards that, although that is the more edited narrative, was because in her confessional, Tommy said, when my sister getting active, I'm getting active too. And jumped down off the security guard and started getting Stunner Girl. So was it really two separate incidents that just broke out at once? It's a possibility. But anyway, that's what they was talking about. On a more positive note, it looks like Krishan fans, I think she coming to the reunion. I think she coming. Every time I see the girls at the wig shop, I be feeling like I know they coming to the reunion. When they start going to that wig shop, you know, Scotty, Stunner, Krishan, they got that same salon logo in the background. I think Natalie must got a contract with them or something. You know, I'm going to bring my cast down here. And, you know, can we get some free wigs? We going to promote y'all. Sure. That's what it's giving to me. But, yeah, that's just a little quick tea for y'all. Was Biggie there? Did Biggie help? I don't know, honey. But it is what it is at one point. I'll tell you that much. It's just going down, y'all. It's crazy. And they not letting up. So, y'all stay locked to the channel. The reunion is being filmed tomorrow. So, look out for your faves looking glamorous and this and that. Because that's letting it be known who coming and who not coming. How do y'all feel about that? Do y'all think Biggie was the one who set up Stunna, or do y'all think it was Tommy? Krishan also had this to say about the situation. She said she feel like Biggie chose the wrong side, and that you know, Biggie basically made a mistake with Si and with Tommy. But my thing is, out of Tommy and Natalie, I'm personally not siding with anyone. I'm gonna be in the middle and side with myself. You know, Team Jen. You know me. I ain't doing that. But y'all let me know how y'all feel about this. Do you really think, I mean, one way or another, the girl was set up. You know what I'm saying? You could see that. But just to know who did it, I don't know. But the thing is, was it two different setups? Was it one? Child, all I know is they got her. They got her, y'all. They got to her quick. It was fast. They got her. Yeah. So I don't know what the reunion going to be giving, but stay locked to the channel because I will keep you up to date on all the latest tea. Remember this. Do the best you can with what you got, and I will see you on my next video.